The chairman of the St. Lucia Coconut Growers Association, Raphael St. Mark, had stated that a significant amount of money was required to get the company going again, and that assistance promised by the Ministry of Commerce and Business Development was not forthcoming. In that regard, the Minister of Commerce and Business Development, Emma Hippolyte, referred to the situation as unfortunate, but said that all is not lost with the facility. The Commerce Minister also stated that a time frame cannot be given in lending support to the copper factory, but the urgency of the matter, she said, was understood. Now, a former employee wants the copper factory opened. Julian Alfo says all that is required is a proper management team to run the facility successfully.
The factory is going down because there is no owner owned by the factory. The factory don't have no owner. So what they have to be done is the government of signature take over the factory and rule the factory. The factory have a lot of potential to do a lot of things, but it's just that we need a proper management group.
The president of the St. Lucia Chamber of Agriculture, Cuthbert Phillips, just recently also weighed in on the issue, saying that government should not provide additional financial assistance to the copper factory. Well, at present, over 20 persons are on the breadline as a result of the closure of the facility. Mr. Alfos believes economic benefits for the Soufriere community are being stifled whilst the copper factory remains closed.
Well, my father, that is where my father worked and sent me to school. And again, I went there, and that is where I work and send my child to school. And again, I build my house and things. So the factory is very important in Soufriere. And I think there is no way the factory can be closed, because if the factory closes, it's a problem for Soufriere. And I think there is so many factories in Vifort. All is in operation. There is so much in Castries, all in operation. And only one in Soufriere and it's closed. It's a shame.
The former employee of the St. Lucia Coconut Growers Association served at the organization for 26 years. The St. Lucia Coconut Growers Association operates the copra factory, which has been in existence since 1939 and produced margarine, magic cooking oil, soaps, and other coconut byproducts until its recent closure. For the DBS News World, Jason Holland, Seed reporting.